पाच एलिमेंट
आहे सर.
दोन तीन पानं भरतील फक्त. राईट, तो कोई भी समझ दिस द एग्जाम्पल गिवन टू यू. क्या करना है अभी देखो, ये सॉल्व से सॉल्व करके दिखाना है. बिफोर दैट वी नीड टू कन्वर्ट दिस ट्री, दिस एलिमेंट टू अ बाइनरी ट्री. हाउ टू डिजाइन अ बाइनरी ट्री यू नो, जस्ट प्लेस ऑल द एलिमेंट्स द वे दे एंटर इन टू द लिस्ट 1, 2 and 5. दिस इज जस्ट अ बाइनरी ट्री दैट वी हैव डिजाइंड फॉर द गिवन लिस्ट ऑफ एलिमेंट. सुनो, बाइनरी सर्च ट्री नहीं है, सिंपल बाइनरी ट्री, सिंपल बाइनरी ट्री. ओके, नाउ आवर जॉब इज टू कन्वर्ट दिस बाइनरी ट्री इनटू मैक्सिव. नाउ व्हाट इज मैक्सिव? इन मैक्सिव एवरी पेरेंट वैल्यू चिल्ड्रन, नो मैटर द चिल्ड्रंस आर प्लेस्ड इन टू मीज इन एनी ऑर्डर, राइट, बट द पेरेंट्स शुड हैव वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन. ओके, now the job is to convert this binary tree into maxip. Is it a maxip? Just focus on the lower part of this diagram. No. Now to prepare it as a maxip, we need to do certain adjustment. Correct. So we need to swap the position of 3 and 5. Correct. 5 will go up. Correct. 4, 5, 1, 2 and 3. These are first adjustment that you have done to convert this into maxif. Again, is the entire tree is a maxif? No, there is a problem with the root node. So again, we need to shift what? Swap.
Swap.
5 and 4.
Five and four, yes.
So that this goes to
5, 4, 3, 1, 3.
And this goes to a root node, right? Now if we check this diagram. Is it a maxip tree?
Yes.
Then what is the rule of maxip? In maxip, every parent node has value larger than his children. So 4 is having the value larger than 2 and 3. 5 is larger than all. Right? So this can be a maxip. So we achieved maxip from the given binary tree. Once you get the maxip, the next step is to give the indices to each and every vertex in the tree or node in the tree. Okay, start giving the indices. The first index root node is having index 0, next image children is having index 1 and 2, next is having 3 and 4. Mm-hmm. After getting the maxif, the next step is to give the indices to each and every element into the or node into the tree. After giving the indices, always swap the root node with last unsorted element of the hip tree. Okay.
Unsorted element.
Unsorted. Okay. All these are unsorted elements. Now, once you do that, swap root node with last unsorted element. In this case, it is 3. Okay. So 3 becomes the root node. 4, 1, 2 and 5. I can say that 5 reached this proper place. So I can say this part of the tree is sorted. Whereas the remaining, the other half, is unsorted. Correct. Forget about 5, ignore it, and only concentrate on the remaining unsorted element, and just tell me, is it a maxif tree?
No.
So you convert the remaining part of the tree, which is into maxif, again into maxif. To do that, 4 will go to the root node, 3 come down, 1, 2 and 5, but we'll ignore it because this is sorted. Is it a maxim? Remain tree? Yes. By ignoring this. Another part is maxim. Again give the indices. The same thing. 0, 1, 2, 3. To the last unsorted element. 3 was the last unsorted. Sorry, 2 was the last unsorted element. And the last index for this is 3. And our rule is what? Once it is in maxim, swap root node with last unsorted. So this become 2 root node 3 1 4 and
5.
I can say that these two elements are now in sorted list.
Okay.
And remaining is
unsorted.
Convert the remaining tree into maxif. So this is not a maxif tree, this part. So we'll shift 3 to the root node. 2, 1, 4 and these two are sorted. And give the indices to only unsorted elements from the root node. 0, 1, 2. Now again the same rule. Again you have to swap what? The root node with the last unsorted index. That is 1. So 1 will go to the root node, 2 on the left hand side, 3 right side, 4 and 5 to the left and right side of 2. These 3 elements are now sorted and these 2 are unsorted. Is the remaining part of the tree maxi? No. So do it just by swapping 1 and 2. Sorted. This remaining part is now again in the maxim. Give the indices from the root node to the last unsorted index, that is 0 and 1. So it means in the last step we have to just do the swapping of these two elements, unsorted elements. So 1 will go to the root node, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now all the elements are now sorted. And this is unsorted. There is no need to swap. So I can say that this is sorted list. To write the sorted list, we have to traverse the tree from root to the last node level wise. Okay. So this is heap sort.
Heap sort is max heap.
There are two methods. One is also min heap.
Opposite.
Opposite of it.